Smith County has annual sales for sheep and goats of just under $250,000. Today we visit Kristen Bellinger at Blue Line Farm to learn more about small ruminant production in Smith County.
Hi, I'm Kristen Bellinger and I'm the owner of Blue Line Farm, Blue Line Farm LLC, and we go by Blue Line Farm TN here. We're located outside Carthage, Tennessee in Smith County, Middle Tennessee. I've owned the farm for about a year and a half, moved here about a year and a half ago after I retired as a police officer in Reno, Nevada, and hence the name Blue Line Farm. I was looking for something to do in retirement that was completely different from what I had done before. I've always loved animals, and I was interested in the idea of raising animals for fleece, for the fiber, and learning about fiber arts. I also have a background in baking and other kitchen cooking and things like that. And so I was looking for a property where I could kind of incorporate a lot of different things. So it took quite some time to find the right property, but I found this place, 37 acres in Smith County. And I've been busy for the last year and a half getting set up. We're still not all the way there, but getting closer by the day. Right now, I've got 26 sheep. Of those, two are Scottish Blackface rams, nine are Scottish Blackface ewes, and they're lambs that were born on the farm. This year, 15 lambs that are 50-50 Scottish Blackface and Valet Blacknose. And that was the first venture that I started on the farm. The Valet Blacknose is a heritage sheep that is not currently in the United States. And so I am part of the Valet Breed Up Program. Here in North America, my association that I belong to is Valet Blacknose Sheep Association of North America. And what we do is start with our foundation ewes, which in my case is Scottish Blackface, import Valet Blacknose semen, and have the girls artificially inseminated and breed up until we get to about a 97% purity, and then it will become a domestic purebred breed. So something I've never been involved with before, know nothing about livestock, know nothing about farming, but it has been a fun adventure. We had 100% success rate with our laparoscopic artificial insemination. I did take the guest house that's on the property and have converted that to a commercial kitchen. It's just about up and running, and we will be producing product from the farm. There's an orchard on the property that needs some work to get going again, but we plan on producing product from that, preserves, pies, things like that. I'll be learning how to do the fiber arts and process the sheep wool and spin and loom and all of that kind of stuff. So we're on Facebook right now as Blue Line Farm TN. Like and follow us. We would appreciate it. And the website is just about ready to go live within the next, hopefully by the end of the month. And then we will have merchandise for sale. And we do farm tours by appointment. So anybody that's interested in coming and seeing the animals or any of this beautiful property, we would love to have you. The most rewarding by far it to me is the livestock and the land as well, in the sense of the stewardship of it. Coming from a career of public service, it has always called to me to serve a purpose bigger than myself, outside myself, and working with the animals and the land keeps me close to God. It's when I do my praying and my reflection, and it serves a purpose outside myself, caring for the animals, and they just bring me so much joy. So that is definitely the most rewarding. We've had the babies born on the farm. I've never had any experience like that. I was able to participate in some of that, had to help with some of the births. So that was definitely an eye-opening experience and really, really rewarding. The challenges, I would say, like any livestock farmer, anybody on the farm that has animals, dealing with death is really tough. Farmers love their animals and care for them. And when you experience death, which you inevitably do, that's really tough. But I knew that was part of it. Fortunately, we haven't had a lot of that, but it does happen. And then the other challenge, I would say, would be the finances. I did a lot of planning and budgeting before I started this venture. I have zero experience in agriculture. And so I spent a lot of time learning and reading and talking to people. But of course, as you live it and go through day by day, there are things you didn't even know to ask about. So I've learned a lot, which has been good for my soul, but it has also been a challenge because there's definite frustrations when I just don't know what to do. But I have been able to develop mentors. I've sought mentorship from people that have a lot of valuable experience for each different species. I've taken advantage, as you know, of the classes offered through the Extension office here in Smith County, and I've learned an enormous amount there and made connections with people. Definitely the budget is hard to stay within, and there's always something coming up that is unexpected. So I guess expect the unexpected. I would say most definitely spend time speaking with and learning from people that have experience. If you can, do as much visiting to farms as possible to see their operation. There's more than one way to do everything on a farm, and so the more visits that you do, it will give you an idea of different ways that things can be accomplished, and then you can learn to adapt that to the land, the structures, whatever it is that you're starting out with. There's no perfect way to do it. Everybody has their own style, but definitely develop those mentorships and learn from people and have people that you can call. The people in the sheep world, the goat world, the farming world in general, the local community have been more than happy to share their experience and mentor and answer questions and help you through it. So that's the biggest thing, is to take all the classes that you can, take advantage of those resources, and reach out to people to expand your knowledge.
Thanks, Kristen, for introducing us to Small Ruminant Production here in Smith County. We hope you've enjoyed this edition of Meet a Farmer Monday.